If you want to improve your writing, you might be thinking about using some free spelling or grammar apps, plugin, or websites. The thing is, are those any good? In today's episode, I'm going to show you the capabilities of some of the free products out there to help you polish your work. Here we go. Some may think that using a spelling or a grammar app as a writer is akin to using auto-tune as a singer. In a way, you are bypassing the skills and discipline of writing, and that is having a good handle of the tools, which are the vocabulary, and the structure, which is the grammar, of the written language. Yet, in this day and age, to not use a tool that is available, it feels like a stupid thing to do. It can be debated that what is important are the ideas being communicated. So if anything that can help you communicate your ideas better should definitely be taken advantage of. And spelling and grammar apps, plugins, and websites are definitely there to help you do that. Personally, I'm a proponent of spelling and grammar apps because writing is not editing. As a writer, you always want another set of eyes to check your work just to catch mistakes that you've made, typos, little grammatical errors, before you send it off to your company to read. Not every writer has the luxury of time and community to review their work, and that is why I think spelling and grammar apps are helpful that way. Also, the writers who choose not to use spelling and grammar apps still have access to them. It's like choosing to walk, but the bus is still there. It's still an option. You can still use it. With all that off my chest, today I want to share with you 4 spelling and grammar tools that are free, available to you right now, but I want to review them to show you what they're capable of, what they will miss, and what they will catch. That way, you can use them strategically in your next project. Alright, here we go, let's get started. So, in order for me to review these tools, I had to write a paragraph full of spelling and grammatical errors to see if these tools can actually catch them. So I wrote one of the worst paragraphs I have ever written. The thing about trying to write a paragraph full of mistakes is actually really hard. Give it a try. So I wrote this really bad paragraph about the city I live in, Vancouver. It includes spelling mistakes, passive voice, run-on sentences, comma splice, stuff like that. So now that I have this paragraph, I'm going to drop it into one of these tools and to see what they actually catch. Alright? So the first tool I want to review is called polishmywriting.com. So here's how it works. I copy my paragraph, my really bad paragraph, and I paste it into the text box and I click check writing. Suddenly all these different color squiggly lines will pop up. So right away, I see that polishmywriting.com missed out on a lot of spelling errors and run-on sentences. But what it did pick up are the complex phrases and words. These are words and phrases I could omit from my story. Kinda. I take a look at the paragraph and what has been underlined, and I don't know if it's super helpful. I think this tool may be useful as a final touch sort of scenario. Maybe after you do a more thorough edit. It definitely missed a lot of spelling mistakes and probably won't save you from any embarrassment if you're relying on it solely. So the next app I want to talk about is the Hemingway app, which is modeled after Ernest Hemingway, who is known for his brevity. Once again, I'll grab my paragraph and I will throw it into the Hemingway app. What is great about this app is that it shows you the readability of your work. So if you're using a really complex word, it'll let you know. If you're using too many words to describe a concept, it'll let you know. If you're using run-on sentences, it'll let you know. What it doesn't do is pick up on spelling mistakes. What it won't do is pick up on grammatical errors. This app is definitely not a spell checker. It should not be used that way. But if you're writing content for a really wide audience, this is actually a really good app because it helps you write in plain English. It shows you where you're being too complicated and how you could simplify it. The next app I want to talk about that you've probably heard about is Grammarly. Now, I'm not reviewing any of the paid version, I'm just reviewing the free version here. These are all free, keep that in mind. I'm gonna open up the Grammarly browser, which link to all these products are in the description. And I'm gonna see what it comes up with. There you go, a bunch of red lines. This looks familiar. So Grammarly actually did a really good job catching most of the spelling errors and punctuation mistakes, but it was not too helpful in catching passive voice, run-on sentences, and vague descriptions. So there you go. Grammarly is probably the best choice so far if what you want is to make sure everything is spelled correctly. So the last app I want to talk about today is Expresso. So while all the other apps today that I reviewed focused on catching mistakes here and there, this one is more of an analyzer. So I'm gonna work the same way. I'm gonna copy and paste that bad paragraph I have into Expresso app, and I get something called metrics for editing. Now, this app has a lot of details and suggestions, and in doing so, it could be a little confusing, especially when all you want is to help check to see if there's any mistakes. This is not really the app for that. If you're not confident in your spelling and grammar in the first place to be able to correct mistakes that have been identified, I don't know if this is the best place to go. Paste your writing in, and then click into each category and try to understand why this word or phrase was highlighted. Not every highlight is a suggestion to change. It's more or less just noted for you to consider. Whether you choose to replace it or not, that is up to you. It's just telling you that that is that. So those are four free spelling and grammar apps and tools for you to consider using. My favorite app in this review is Grammarly. I think it's the most useful one. It has a plugin. It catches little spelling and grammar mistakes. Just when you're moving quickly, it's a good tool to have just to clean up your writing really fast. My runner-up is definitely the Hemingway app if what I'm writing needs to be clear and concise. I hope you found this video helpful. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button. And if you want to see more writing tips, tricks, ideas, inspirations, please subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.